then I'm just gonna let go of the brakes and the car will do the rest for us.
You're not doing anything?
No, not at all. See.
Bosch on yksi maailman suurimmista alihankkijoista autoteollisuudessa ja sen takia Boschin teknologia löytyy lähes jokaisesta automerkistä. Ajattelepa vaikka sun lempiautomerkkiä. Hyvällä todennäköisyydellä siitäkin löytyy Boschin teknologia. Me ollaan täällä upeassa Boschin innovaatiokeskuksessa Budapestissa. Tässä jaksossa me tutustutaan Boschin ekspertteihin ja samalla me tutustutaan, mitä he tekevät täällä ja minkä takia he ylipäätänsä tekevät näitä asioita. Lähdetään ottamaan selvää. Bosch on paljon muuta kuin pelkästään koodinkoneet tai työkalu. Nimittäin Bosch voisi kutsua melkein high-tech powerhouseksi, joka ottaa jatkuvasti edistysaskeleita esimerkiksi AI:n kanssa sekä terveydenhuollossa että monessa muussa asiassa. Boschin teknologia löytyy kaikkialta. Puhelimista, kameroista, autoista, sähköpyöristä, julkisesta liikenteestä sekä muualta. Boschin teknologiat auttaa tohtoreita, astronautteja sekä totta kai sua sekä mua.
Daniel!
Yes?
Hello!
Hey!
Nice to meet you, Rasmus.
Nice to meet you, I'm Daniel.
Tässä jaksossa tutustutaan Danieliin. Hän on superiso autofanaatikko, jonka intohimo autoihin alkoi jo pienen lapsena. Hän tiesi jokaisen automerkin ennen kuin osasi edes puhua. Boschilla Daniel työskentelee insinöörinä, joka keskittyy pysäköintijärjestelmän integrointiin sekä autojen testaukseen. Kaupungit tulevat ruuhkaisemmiksi ja autot isonevat. Hän pyrkii tekemään parkkeerausteknologiasta intuitiivista sekä luotettavaa. Daniel näkee parkkeerausteknologian kehittyvän itsestään ajavien autojen kanssa, ja tärkeä osa tätä on varmistaa saumaton integraatio itsenäisestä ajamisesta itsenäiseen parkkeeraamiseen.
Is parking hard for you, or why are you doing this?
No, personally for me not, but I know a lot of people, and we have a history, for instance, in our family, for 3 generations now, with people involved in driving. So they're officially holding a driver's license, but they are so afraid of parking that they forgot to enjoy all that comes with driving, all the freedom and all the experience. So that's my personal mission, to change that.
I can tell you that I'm one of those persons. Oh. I love to drive with a car, but the parking is my...
It's your kryptonite.
Yeah, exactly. it's hard. But luckily, there's people like you helping us out. So what can you tell about the car?
At first sight, this might seem like a regular road car.
Yeah.
But actually, this is one of our development vehicles. That's a GPS antenna, just to make sure we're accurate enough in our data recordings. There are some special screens you won't normally see in a regular car, as well as all of the wires going to the back, where really the magic happens. So.
What? What is going on?
I thought you were going to be surprised.
Yeah, there's like plenty of cables and what are these things?
Well, on some of our cars, we use 1 or 2 kilometers of cables to make sure everything's wired. What you can see inside is basically where all the data gets consolidated. All the data from the sensors in terms of ultrasonic sensors, cameras and so on are collected and merged together. So this can be used in our development. So you see an industrial PC here as well. Yeah, that's a PC.
That one?
Yeah, that's a high-performance PC, that huge black box.
Lähdetään tutustumaan tuohon PC:hen enemmän, koska toi näyttää ihan älyttömän siistiltä. So, you tell me about this industrial PC. I'm a huge gamer myself. Mm-hmm. I do a lot of gaming. So, what do you think about the specs? Because I'm a huge like specs guy. I want my FPS, everything to work perfectly when I'm gaming. So. Mm-hmm. How do you compare that to like a normal gaming PC?
It's not fully optimized for the gaming purposes, but it is managing all that huge amount of data what we are processing. So it definitely has multiple times the performance in terms of processing. So the processor and the memories inside are definitely increased compared to a general gaming PC.
Yeah, for sure.
As well as the storage devices. However, we are more and more going into the cloud, so that's why we have different routers and so on to have a stable connection to the network. We need to process about 1 or 2 gigabytes of data every second, so just imagine that a regular phone would be full in 2 minutes.
Yeah. Boschin innovaatiota löytyy nykyään lähes jokaisesta automerkistä, joten lähdetään ottaa selvää, että kuinka monesta. Mä kysyn Danielilta automerkkejä, hän vastaa kyllä tai ei. Katsotaan, miten tämä menee. Okay, Daniel, you ready for a quiz?
Yeah, sure, go
I'm
ahead.
I'm gonna ask that if Bosch innovation is on some car brands.
Okay.
So you have to be honest.
I will.
Okay. First one, how about
yes. 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 It's not a surprise. You can find a Bosch product in basically each and every vehicle, and I'm not meaning that you should put a dishwasher or something in a trunk. But definitely you'll find at least one Bosch product in every single vehicle, and you don't have to search it for long.
So we're talking about cables and everything, but how about if we just try it?
Yeah.
Is it possible?
Sure, that's the best part of it. Let's make use of it.
Yeah, let's go. Well, this just looks like a regular car.
Yeah, it definitely is. It's something you can already buy from the market. But don't be surprised, all of those tens of thousands of hours what we put into that vehicle to develop this solution went and concluded into this particular car and all the others on the streets. With just a single press of a button, we're going to ask the car to measure the surrounding parking spots if they are large enough and suitable for the car to fit in. The sensors are measuring the different dimensions, both the ultrasonic sensors and the cameras. And as you will see soon on the screen, it offers you the available parking slots. See, there's one.
Oh!
So I'm gonna just push the touchscreen and choose to reverse in.
Oh, you can decide which way you wanna go in.
Yeah, exactly, whatever you prefer. Then I'm just gonna let go of the brakes and the car will do the rest for us.
You're not doing anything?
No, not at all. See, here are my legs, my feet as well.
Wow.
And you'll see on the screen what the car is up to.
You're sure you're still not pressing anything?
No, not at all. No tricks, no magic.
Wow. But this is magic.
Yeah.
This is magic. It's made by you.
Yeah, definitely. So what basically has been happening is that the car created a sort of map around the surroundings of the car itself. And based on the programs, the algorithms running on the computer, it made its own decisions and acted like it's supposed to.
I have an idea. Maybe I'll go out, you do it again, and I see it from other perspective.
Okay, sure, go
That's
ahead.
Fine.
No niin, katsotaan selviytyykö Auto ja Daniel tästä haasteesta. Äsken näytti helpolta, mutta nyt me nähdään tässä, että miltä toi oikeasti näyttää. Wow. Upeeta. Mä haluan oikeasti nähdä. Että toimiiko toi oikeesti? Eli laitetaan tää lapsi ton auton eteen ja katsotaan tunnistaako noi kamerat tän. Vähän jo rupeaa jännittää tän lapsen puolesta, mutta kohta me nähdään.
Why did you stop?
There's a dummy behind me.
I may have done something. Oh. I wanted to test it out. Your team is the reason why that type of things are possible.
Yes, exactly. It's been quite a journey, but I'm confident that there's still a lot to go and we have quite good potentials here.
What do you think about the future?
Let me show you instead. So first, it might seem just a regular vehicle, but you can find some extraordinary details. For instance, on the rooftop, this is one of the cars that the colleagues are currently working on. And this is the, let's say, the next evolutionary step of parking systems. Those are LiDARs, by the way. On the rooftop, so like rotating lasers, which are all collecting data, just helping us to really collect all that's required to feed our development.
Yeah.
On top, we have the corner radars, as well as the ultrasonic sensors and the regular cameras.
Yeah.
So the principles are the same, but definitely with increasing computing powers, as well as introducing AI solutions in terms of image chains and basically processing the vision features. So there's a lot more going on. I think there's a quantum leap ahead.
What do you think about the future? Do I actually need a driving license?
I'm quite certain that we will reach a point where you won't. So once level 4 and level 5 autonomous driving cars will be more common, I think there will be a point when you don't necessarily need one.
Thank you, Daniel. It was a pleasure to be here at Boss Innovation Garage with you.
Siis tää oli ihan mahtava kokemus päästä tänne Boschin autotalliin katselemaan, minkälainen meininki on nyt ja minkälainen meininki tulee tulevaisuudessa. Voi olla, että mun lapsenlapset ei välttämättä tarvii ikinä koskaan ajokorttia edes.
Kiitos kun katoitte. Toivottavasti tykkäsitte yhtä paljon niin kuin meitsi ja toivottavasti te opitte myös samalla jotain uutta. Ensi kerralla, kun sä istasat autoon tai selotat puhelinta, mieti hetki, minkälaista teknologiaa Boschilta sulla saattaa olla siinä laitteessa. Jos sä tykkäsit tästä videosta, niin käy tsiigaamassa 2 muuta videota. Ne löytyy Bossin YouTubesta tai Bossin sivustolta. Ei muuta kuin nähdään ensi videon parissa. Moi!